Hi guys, Nancy here from Illumicious. Welcome to part one of the Akita puppy. We will be creating this one. This will be part one and we're going to start with the stomach this time. So check this out. This one is orange and white. I will now use the second one I'm going to make will be a brown color from the camo mix from Raymaloon and simply white, but you can also use a tan color instead of white if you want to. And you can find the band count below in the description with all my tutorials. There is a band count below this video in the description and you can find more information there about my tutorials and things. So check it out. If you want to know how many bands you need, obviously you just can change the brown color to orange or any other color. You can use gray or black or another brown color. So let's start creating this beautiful puppy. We're going to start with the stomach, so make sure your loom is set up like this with a arrow shape here, offset, and grab your stomach color that can be tan or white or any other color you desire. So two bands at a time and follow me. Again, I'm going to do this tutorial backwards. I like doing that. No, we will do the legs and the head next. Two bands all the time. Still a bit rusty, by the way. I do loom, of course, but we had a lot of things happening here with our kids and pets. One of our pets, we let him, we put him down. He was sick. Or actually, she was sick. I do have to count now. I'm sorry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We need to go down 7 times with 2 bands. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. One more time. Yeah, she was sick. So we had her put down yesterday. It was very sad. A sad moment. It was a guinea pig. So, two diagonally there. Yeah, it was very sad. But the right thing to do, since she was sick and she wouldn't eat and drink anymore, well, it's better for her. So that was one of the things that made me postpone this tutorial. So postpone, I meant diagonally here, but it's okay. And down with 2 bands. I hope I didn't make you guys sad. It was the right thing to do. Well, anyways, we're going to place the horizontal bands. So this will be your stomach. There isn't actually a front and back, but it's the same on the front and the back. You have to place horizontal bands, but double loop them. You can also double loop a band and stretch it across. It doesn't have to be neat. You won't see them. Like this, all the way until you can't place any horizontal bands anymore. All need to be double looped bands. And that's it for the stomach. Turn your loom. Have it like this. Place a single band. Wrap it around 4 times. or actually three, make four loops around that peg. That's the cap band. And now we will place loose bands so we can stitch it to the stomach. I will use brown. If you are making an orange dog, you will use orange for this. This is one band. Place it there. Now grab two bands of your body color. Place them there and two here. Lay them loose around the pegs. We will loom over them. So that's for the main body color. Now grab white bands or tan color. Well, your stomach color. And simply lay a single loose band around the pegs. Put them there. I will turn my loom. You can see better where I place them. So loose bands all that way. Place two loose stomach color bands around this pack. And now I do have to check, why did I swap that to? Isn't there so necessary, I guess? Yeah, well, I'm gonna trust myself. I wrote this down a month ago, so grab your main body color, place two here. And that's it. You only need one main body color to tie off. So let us loom. Go behind your cap bands. Grab the bottom two bands and loom over. Pretend those loose bands aren't there and loom past them. Diagonally this way, and you can actually do diagonally that way. Already. Now we need to loom this side first, this row. So continue looming, go behind your horizontal bands and forget about that loose band and just loom over them. There we go. Also loom this one diagonally. And then we can do the other row. So going back to the bottom. And also loom this. I'm sorry if I'm off screen. Simply loom up, loom diagonally, and loom the final two. Go behind all these bands here, only grab the bottom two, and loom over. Now grab a single main body color band, and make a slip knot here. And this will be the stomach. Remove this from your loom. What happened there? Oh, that's my horizontal band coming through. But pull outwards those loose bands. Pull one to the left and one to the right where you placed two of them. That's about it for the stomach. So this will be your stomach. And we're going to continue with the legs. Put it aside, you don't need it just now. Set up your loom in a rectangular shape for the legs. No, I will have my loom like this, I'm sorry. Grab two bands at a time. I'm going to start with the main body color. This will be the front leg, two bands. Now swap to white or your tan color, also two bands at a time. Now we're going to place two diagonally. Grab three bands at a time now, so the leg will be a little bit thicker. These are three bands. We need to go down three times with three bands. That's it. We only need to create a paw, but first we're going to place the horizontal bands, double loop a single white here, and another double looped there. Now we're going to create the paws. I already made them, but I will show you how to do this once. So you can actually decide to create your paws first before putting on the legs, but it's up to you if you want to do that. We're going to create nails. You need 16 of those. Make a figure eight with a single band, nail color band. Twist it again, place it upwards. I will show you again. Lift up this band. Let go. Grab the bottom here, the bottom loop, and also flip it over. Now there's a knot in the center, and this will be one nail. I will show you again. You have to create 16 of those. So a single white band, figure eight. This is a figure eight, like this. You grab the band again, you twist it the other way and place it upwards. Grab this band, let go. Grab the bottom here, this one, and also flip over. So create 16 nails. I will have to create two more, by the way. I forgot about those. It ain't hard, but you need to get the hang of it. It's quite simple to do so, if your bands stay around the peg. Like this. So I have four nails lying in front of me. I will show you this without my loom. All those nails need to be around my hook, all four of them. So slide them onto your hook. There we go. Now grab a single white band or your paw color. I don't know what you are using. Double loop that band. Hold it with your finger and slide over all those nails there. Flip the knots so they will face to your right. Like this. Push down. Grab two white bands. Slide it over your hook once and wrap it around two more times. So there's a tiny chunk, and replace the double looped band. Sort this out so it will look neat. Something like this. Grab three more white bands or your leg color. Hold it with your finger and slide everything onto there in order. So take your time to do this. I always sort this out a little bit. Make it look as good as I can. So here we go. Here we have a paw. So create four of those. You can already do that if you prefer to pre-make them. So this is the paw. It's on your hook like this. We're going to place all the 6 loops around this peg. And then all we have to do is loom up. And there we go. You have your front leg. So go behind all those bends there. Grab the bottom 3 and loom over. The next. The next, grab the top 2 only, diagonally, bottom 2, upwards. And continue looming upwards until you reach the end of your loom. Now grab 2 bands of any color and create slip knots so your work won't fall apart. Carefully remove the paw or the leg from the loom. And this will be 1 front leg. Like this. Create a second one exactly the same. And now we're going to do the back leg. We'll be quite similar, actually almost the same. 2 main body color bands first, and the rest will be white. So switch to white. To diagonally, all with 2 bands. I don't know if I already said that. I probably did, but I don't know. So 2 bands at a time. Now we need to place 3 again, so the leg will be thicker. Yeah, these are 3. 3 white bands at a time, going down 3 times. Grab a single white band. Excuse me. And double loop it here. Grab 2 bands and place it here as a horizontal band. Well, if you did make other paws, you can place it here at the bottom. And if you forgot how to make them, well, rewind this video so you can see how I did this with the front leg and create another paw. So place it there like this, go behind the bands, grab the bottom 3 and loom upwards. And again, only grab the top 2 bands here, loom over diagonally. You can actually already loom up this entire row. Only grab the top 2, loom diagonally, loom upwards this row. And the last stitch loomed. Again, grab 3 bands of another color. Create some slip knots here. Obviously, you need to make a second back leg. You can do it exactly the same. No need to mirror anything. Remove it from your loom. Like this, create a second back leg exactly the same way. And now we will do the head. I do have to swap my looms around. I have 2, 1 in offset and 1, well, in a rectangular shape. The head. We're going to start with the ears. Obviously, you also need to create two, but I will only show you how to make one because I already did the other one. So grab your main body color, double loop bands only. So singles, double looped. Doesn't matter where you are on your loom, just follow me. Double loop a single main body color band here. Here. Can you guys see this? Yes, I guess you can. Only one band and one double looped here. Also on the opposite side, but we're going to skip one here. That's correct. So don't place it here, but here. Also a double looped single. Double looped single here. And diagonally upwards. And here too, of course. Grab a single band again. Wrap it around five times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Adjust this a tiny bit so it looks kind of neat. Double loop a single main body color band and place it here. That will be your horizontal band. And another double looped here. Now grab your inner ear color. This can be, I forgot about them by the way, but this can be white or pink. I will do pink, I guess. Skin tone pink. Grab a single pink band. Wrap it around three times. Lift up the horizontal band. Slide everything onto there. And replace. We have to do this a second time. So wrap it around your hook three times. There are three pink loops there. Lift up the horizontal band and replace. Slide it over and replace. This will be the ear. You can actually, if you did this on top of your loom, you can place the other ear exactly beneath it. So, or on another loom. Go behind the cap band. Grab the first band you come across and loom diagonally. Grab the next. And simply loom upwards. Those bands. That's it. This will be one ear. Well, grab two different color bands again and make slip knots. This will be the ear. You might need to pull a bit on that ear, I will show you, in order to give it the right shape. So it's from my loom now, it looks kind of weird and totally, well, squashed. But stick your hook through the cap band and carefully sort this out a tiny bit and pull upwards. If you do that, the ear will become, well, a little bit pointy. This will do. Remove your hook and it will look like this, so that's better. Create a second ear. Exactly the same, because we can flip them around. But you do have to be careful how you attach them to the top of the head. So watch me closely as I do that. So create two and get back to this point. We will continue with the top of the head now. Two bands at a time of your main body color first. Okay, guys, follow me here. So, two bands at a time. Now grab your white color two in the center and diagonally. Grab two white bands again and create a horizontal band here, triangle shape, but don't place the other one yet. I'm sorry guys, there's something stuck in my throat. I hope I won't be getting sick again. I don't want that. Grab your ears. There is a short side on your ear and a long side. Actually, there's one loop, one set of bands longer on one side. So have your ear like this. We need to stick our hook through from the back to the front on the short side and have that long piece on the right side. So it's need to be on your hook like this. This is the long side that's not around your hook. The short side is around your hook. So like this. I will turn my loom for this. We need to slide it onto these two bands. So lift them up and slide over the short side of the ear. And the longest side of the ear is facing towards you. Replace. And just leave this hanging, that long side, that's fine. The other ear needs to be done in the opposite direction. So now we have the longest side on our left. And we go with the hook from the back to the front on the short side. But the long side is now on the other side of my hook. We're also going to place it around these two bands. Lift them up, slide the ear over. If you have done dogs with me before, you know what to do, but I can't just see if you have done tutorials with me before or not, of course. So grab two bands again. We're going to place the final horizontal band here. Your ears can be in front of that horizontal band. It doesn't matter. Well, like this. It's a bit messy, but we will just loom past it. Grab a white band. Wrap it around four times to create a horizontal band. Cap band, sorry. Go behind that white band you just placed by wrapping it around four times and simply grab two bands at a time and loom. Apart. I'm not going to attach the side of the ear yet. So you can loom, but pull it out there. So that longer side is loose and can come around the head later. So you can just loom over it, but do maneuver it upwards after you loomed. Like this. This will be the top of the head. Grab three bands of another color and make slip knots. Carefully remove this from your loom. It will look weird, totally weird, but that's fine. You can actually, if you want to, remove those tying bands here at the bottom. And I hope you attach them correctly. Otherwise, your ear will come off. Why am I doing that with my nails? Why? While I have my hook here. No clue. This one is a little bit tight. So I hope I can untie it with my hook. Yes. Only those two can be removed. The rest will need to be remain there. Kind of pulling on that cap end in front. So this will be the top of your head with the ears on top, of course. I'll put this aside for now. We will need it soon. But we're going to do the middle portion of the head right now. So grab your main body color again and use two bands at a time. Two bands at a time, guys. Unless I tell something different, tell something else. These are simply two main body color bands at a time. All we need to do is place white bands right now. Two here. Three. You need three now. Place them here. And the rest will be double looped. I will turn my loom, otherwise I can't place double loop bands. Single white double looped here. Single white double looped there. Same thing on the opposite side. Like this. And of course also in the center. Double looped. Single. And a double looped single. Also need to place a double looped single diagonally. And one here, double looped. Now grab a black band or your nose color band. Wrap it around this peg four times. Actually using round bands from the metallic mix from Rainbow Loom. They are a tiny bit shiny. And it kind of represents a wet dog nose. These bands. There's a tiny sparkle in them. But I love them for noses. So, Grab your white bands again. Well, at least one white band. Have your loom like this. Grab one white band. Wrap a single band. This is actually the first time. Slide it onto your hook and wrap it around twice. So you will have three tiny loops on your hook. Lift up this double loop band and slide this tiny chunk on there. And replace that band. On the opposite side, we need to do this as well. So, wrapped around three times. And place the bands there. Or slide it over and replace that double loop band. Horizontal bands, double looped white bands. Create a triangle. Another double looped white band. Here, another one, truly, yes. Placed there, I guess the rest will be with two bands at a time, yeah, yes. But now switch to your main body color and grab two bands at a time. Did I do that there? Yeah, I have to. And two bands here. And two here. So this will be the middle portion of the head. Now we're going to make some eyes. So grab your eye color band, a single band. I will remove my loom. Wrap it around twice. Then grab a black band, hold it with your finger. Wrap around four times. Grab that single eye color band again and wrap around two times. This will be one eye. Grab your main body color band, a single band, double loop it, and slide the eye onto there. All those loops need to be around it. My eye is looking kind of weird right now. Totally weird, I guess, but... well, nothing I can do about it. We have to place that eye with a good part of the eye, because you do have a tiny cross on the back, towards the nose. So place it from the fourth peg on the side. Let me check. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, to the fifth in the center. It's almost... so, one side there, one side here. Create a second eye exactly the same way. Also grab a single band, double loop it, main body color band, and slide everything onto there. Here we have the second eye. Place it exactly on the opposite side. Good part needs to face towards the nose. And this will be the middle portion of the head. So let us continue with looming. Go behind that nose band. Grab the first double loop band you come across. And loom over. Do this carefully. They can snap, but I hope they don't. Continue looming up until you reach the eyes. So stop after looming those three bands. Now we're going to loom upwards the side. But I do have to check my design here. The second brown. Okay. Loom up once more. Or can we loom already? 1, 2. I'm checking my diagram in between. Loom up once more. So loom up four times on the sides. We need to attach the ear there. So stop there. Don't continue after these. Grab the top of your head. These represent the back of the head. Those three loose tying bands. So I have it like this. The ears are facing upwards. But you need to stick your hook through... from the top of the head through the bottom. So you need to flip it over. So it's upside down and the ears are facing down. Now you need to stick your hook through the first set in the center row. So these will be white or tan. So not the cap band, but the first set in the center. You need to stick your hook through there, through that set. You need to check on the top of the head if you have two loops of that color on both sides of your hook. So I'm through correctly. So I have it on my hook like this. It's kind of heavy, so it's turning around. So my hook like this. So stick your hook through from, well, like this. This is the top of the head. This is the bottom. Now grab these white bands from inside the eyes. Grab them. Don't loom them yet. So have them on your hook and slide over the head with the tying bands facing towards you. Slide over and then loom. Loom upwards twice more in the center only. Now we need to flip over the head. So it's like this and you need to flip it over. So the ears will come upwards again. But first we have to attach the ears. Stick your, I will do this on its side. So it's like this. Stick your hook through that ear, that bottom set from the back to the front. You can check yourself by removing that tying band, if it's possible for me to do that. Yes, so I have four tiny loops around my hook here, and they need to be slide over onto this loomed set. So you need to lift up that set, both of them, not only one, of course. So I lifted up that set, we loomed, and we need to slide over those four loops onto there. And replace again. I can't see if I'm around my peg because I'm working my loom from the side. So replace that set again. And we need to do this on the opposite side as well. So stick your hook through from the back to the front. You can remove the tying band already. So four loops around my hook. Lift up the bands here and slide it over. And replace. And that's it for the ears. Continue looming up once more on both sides. Now we're going to remove some part of the snout. Do this carefully, especially with the double loop bands. You don't want them to snap. We're not completely done yet, I know, because we have some loose ends here. We still need to attach those to these three pegs. I'm going to start in the center. I'm going to remove the tying band. I have four loops around my hook and I will place them here. And loom over the final set. We need to do this on the sides too. So stick your hook through from the top to the bottom. Remove the tying bands, place them here. All of those loops, of course, all four of them. And loom over the final set. The last set on the side here. Make sure you stick your hook through correctly. Voice. Oh, I'm losing one band there. How will I get that back? With a second hook. There we go. Place those around here. And loom up this final set too. So it will be less tight that way. Grab three single bands again and make slip knots. And carefully remove this part of the head from the loom. Like this, you might need to adjust this a tiny bit. Make the good part of the eye come out a little bit more. You might want to pull those ears to the back of that set where you place them. So I'm just pulling those bands through a tiny bit. This might be a bit tight, so kind of shape your Akita. By the way, the shout out goes to @CarlaC. So Carla, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial and will make a Akita. And show me, post a picture on Instagram or Facebook or both. I would love to see your Akita and I hope you will enjoy this tutorial. That would be awesome if you do. And if you create your Akita, I would love to see your color variation, Carla. So I hope you enjoy. Well, this will be the top of the head. And now we're going to make the bottom jaw and neck. So put this cute top of the head thingy aside. Grab your loom again and follow me. First, we're going to place the neck, also two bands at a time, and use your main body color. So two bands at a time. Only the white that we will add will be double looped, but these are two bands at a time. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We need to go down 6 times on each side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. With two bands of your main body color. That looks like a band that might snap, so I'm replacing that one. Exactly the same thing on the opposite side, of course. Now we're going to do the center. We only need to place 3 sets of 2 main body color bands. The rest will be with white, but now 2 white at a time. One, two, three. Yeah, go down 3 times with 2 white bands. Like this. The rest will be with double looped single white bands. So I will turn my loom again. One here, one double looped white bands here, also in the center. Double looped single white bands. Same thing here, double looped white. Ooh. That one went away. And diagonally here, also double looped. Push down. It's hard for me to do this on its side. Well, this will be the bottom jaw. Grab a single white band. Wrapped it around this peg 4 times. I didn't even count and it flipped off. So grab a new one. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, this will be the cap band. So we can start looming. In a sec, because we need to place the horizontal bands, double looped white bands. So double loop it and place it here. And of course we need to make the tongue. Needs to be in a triangle shape, but you can do that like this too. Also double looped white bands here, I guess 3 times. Yes. Like this, the rest will be with 2 bands at a time and your main body color. So grab 2 of your main body color until you reach the end of your loom. like this. We need some pink bands. I will turn my loom and do the tongue here. Grab a single pink band, double loop one single pink band, then grab two bands of pink, grab another one, and wrap it around three times. So you create a cap band with three loops, and loom this. This will be the tongue, won't be that big. You can actually leave this here on your loom. Yeah, we can loom, guys. Go behind your cap band. Grab the first double loop band you come across and loom diagonally. Grab the next. It's quite loose for... Well, that's fine. Loom up, I guess, three times. I do have to check. Two, three. Yeah, three times. Now grab your tongue. Have it on your hook. And simply place it around this peg you just loomed up to in the center. And now we continue looming in the center a couple of more times. I guess all the white bands. Yeah. Loom up until here. Don't continue any further. Now we're going to start on the sides and we only need to loom up twice. Yeah, twice on both sides. Then we need to grab our top of the head thingy. Looks so cute. We need to stick our hook through this set here beneath the eye. But don't grab these bands that are near the eye, but grab, look at it from its side. Grab these two loops and the bottom two loops of the set from the side. It's important you do it that way, otherwise it will look really weird. So have it on your hook like this. Doesn't matter how it's hanging, by the way, but grab two bands from inside here. Just grab them, just like we did with the top of the head. You have them on your hook. Oh, I'm doing this. No, I'm doing this right. Yeah. And slide it over here. The nose will have to face towards you. But you can't actually do this wrong if you see where I put my hook through. And loom up twice. Now we do need to do the same thing on the opposite side. So here we have the head. There are two loops. Don't grab them near the eye, but grab the next two here. Those are the top two loops. And grab the first two loops you come across from the bottom. Don't grab the horizontal bands. These bands need to be around your hook. So you're going through the stitch you loomed from the side. So there are still a loop, two loops here beneath the eye, but you're only grabbing the top two, bottom two. Now go inside this peg again, reach for those two bands and slide over the head or pull those two bands through and loom further. And continue looming upwards two times. Now we're going to remove the bottom jaw from the loom, not entirely, but a tiny bit. Otherwise, we need to stretch his head too far and it will snap. So remove some part of the bottom jaw from the loom, not further than this. Stop here. Now we still have three loose ends that need to be attached to those three pegs. The rest will be the neck. And simply will need to be loomed upwards. Oh, I'm missing one band again here. I need to be more careful. Well, place all those loops around that peg and simply loom upwards the entire middle row. That's done already. Now we need to do the sides exactly the same way. Place it around this peg here. All four loops, but most of the time I start with two. All four loops need to be around there. Grab only the bottom two and continue looming upwards the row on the left. There we go. And the final set. Also stick your hook through there. Remove that tying band. You don't have to remove them. Attach it to this peg you just loomed up to. And continue looming upwards the entire neck of the Akita. Grab three tying bands to create some slip knots. This will be the head and neck, by the way. So that's done in one portion instead of attaching the neck later. Carefully remove the Akita head from the loom. You might need to squeeze it a tiny bit and shape it a tiny bit. Although I think it looks cute. She looks cute already, or he. Might want to squeeze that bottom jaw a little bit so it will get a round shape. There are some bands here that are a bit, little bit loose. I wanted to say a bit of lid instead of a little bit. That's weird. I always have that in my own language, in Dutch. Sometimes I just say things backwards or I'm swapping some letters around. I don't know why. That just happens. I guess I'm kind of nuts. And weird. And now it's happening in English too. So it has to be me and not the language. Well, anyways, this is your Akita head. I think it's adorable. It looks cute. Yeah, it does. And this will be the end of part one. So Carla and all the others that are watching this, I hope you enjoyed part one so far. You should have created a head with neck completed in your own color you prefer and like. You should have made a stomach, two front legs and two back legs. So I hope you enjoyed so far and I'll see you guys in part two. Bye bye.